Yes, what you see here is the actress, writer also, Roseanne Barr. Now the question, what she is to do with me? I did not watch what she is, the comedies she's doing. But a very interesting story is that she saw my books and she liked them very much. And she asked a friend in Israel how to get him, to get me. So a friend called me, sent me an email, he said, Roseanne Barr wants to see her because she saw your books and she likes them. Can you meet her? I said, this is what he told me, and he told me then, when you are in Los Angeles, try to go to get her, this is her phone number, meet with her. So amazing that exactly I got this email when I was in Los Angeles. So then I asked my friend, Richard Shaw, the producer of our work, the documentary. So I said, "Big take me to Roseanne. She wants to see me." So he brought me to her in Hollywood there. Came in, oh yes, she came and she said, "Yeah, I know your books. Very nice books." And then we spoke a few hours really. And as I heard that she was studying Kabbalah, learning Kabbalah, appreciating Kabbalah, maybe not exactly the Kabbalah that we are doing, but learn Kabbalah. And she taught Kabbalah. So really, it was part of her. She felt, she said that this gives her life and so on. Okay, but unfortunately, you know, that she did not keep Judaism, the Torah, mitzvot, as it is. Her parents were Jewish, but also they became Mormons. Her grandmother was a really Orthodox Jew, learning and really keeping Torah mitzvot properly. But this is really what she was, and as we spoke a lot, I gave him my books, and then really I showed him about the code, the Torah code. She was very impressed for it. And she felt that it's something beyond, because really it isn't doing Kabbalah. So what I'm going to show you today, a Bible code, which I did, with her name, with other details. And let us see where it came, and maybe we'll have some important message from this for us Jews. I speak differently, Jews who keep Torah. Now this is really the table which I found, and to tell you really it was not so easy to find, because you need the date, the year that she was born, which is here, which is 5713, which is really 1952. Then you need the month. The month is Cheshvan Yud K. Yeah, it is 15. Yeah, the 15th of Cheshvan she was born. This month in Hebrew is November. And this is very important, as this makes the table significant. Why? The first thing I saw, it appeared in the book of Deuteronomy, which is against our millennia. Hey, you can see it. Then, the appearance of the year 5713 is a minimal in the book of Deuteronomy, right? And this is the book where she found, and according to Dr. Rotenberg, who really, because of the codes, became religious Jew, keeping the Torah, Sabbath, and everything. And this is really his program. He told me that things which appear in one book are more significant. So here you have, this is, as I said, minimal in the book of Deuteronomy itself is very significant. Then the month, I think it is the second one, which is itself also important because it comes the same table. And then, as I said, she's very much involved in Kabbalah, believing Kabbalah. Interesting that even a Kabbalah comes here. Yeah, telling us that really maybe you should do more in Kabbalah, in the proper way of Kabbalah. Very interesting, a Kabbalah comes here, which is minimal in Deuteronomy. Now what she is doing, Mishak, she's like an actor, so she's really Mishrat, acting. This is what he is doing. But her name is important. This is her name, Rosen. You can see really from the bottom to the top, Rosen Bar, in black here, Rosen Bar. And this is now what really the verses around it said. Not so positive. They speak about the calm Amazon, Moses after, before his death, just before his death, said about the future. He said, these people, unfortunately, who keep Torah, come. Will go astray after Elohim, after other gods, which is really the numerical value. Elohim Achar is really Jesus, by the way. And if you know, she was unfortunately Mormons, for a while. And then it's written there that this forsake me, will not keep the Torah, unfortunately, will break my covenant. No, unfortunately, no, this is the condition that she came into this Hollywood and so on. Like Rabbi Streisand, the same story. She was really studying in Yeshiva, in Flatbush, and because of her talent, she unfortunately went away from the Jewish way, the Torahic way. By the way, she also liked my books, and therefore she sent her corrector, Yentel, Mendy Patenkin, to study with me in Or Samech, the Yeshiva Or Samech in Jerusalem, to prepare him for the movie, because he was playing like Yeshiva, but very nice fellow. He was there for, instead of 2 days, he was for about 2 weeks, and then Barba threatened him, if he's not coming back, there's no more movie for him. So, okay, but it is also interesting that somehow actress like my books, because my books really show the beauty of the Hebrew language and to his Kabbalah. And this is something really which artists like to see, the beauty and harmony. Now, also another verse which said, unfortunately, also went astray to other gods. But altogether, all these verses really speak about a time prophecy which says that in the future, Moses said, Jews will go astray, will worship idols, and will break the covenant with God, and troubles will come. No, I don't know if these troubles that she have now has to do with this, but this is what is written here. So, but always there is a way. Tshuva, repentance, come here. Everything can be rectified by doing tshuva, by repentance. So very, very interesting, significant table, as he said in one book. Minimal, the year that she was born. Second minimal, the date of the month that she was born, the 50th, and minimal Kabbalah really shows that she has inner feelings inside of Kabbalah. Okay, maybe it was not used in the right way, but it shows that she really. But unfortunately, the things, if not going in the right way, can bring to wrong things happening. So this is exactly the table which I think. Very interesting one, significant one. Minimal best meeting, this Dr. Rottenberg says that this is, which makes Torah code, Bible code significant. So, okay, as I said, we had a very nice meeting. So we spoke a lot about Kabbalistic ideas. It means that she knew about the spheres, about so, and she really told me she read my books and she has her very much, but apparently, is not enough to change people which are really very much in all this industry of movies. So, important, interesting table.